Hey everybody, welcome to this tutorial on how to make an awesome movie trailer in iMovie. I'm going to show you a few clips from the trailer I made, and then we'll get right to it.
In a world where peace prevails and kindness is common, a force has emerged which could threaten the very foundations of mankind. But there is one man who has the chance to save it all.
Okay, so first things first, open iMovie, go to File, New Project, then go to Movie Trailers. You can pick whichever one you like, it doesn't matter. Just pick the one you like the music and the titles of and choose that. I chose Blockbuster because I like the Blockbuster. Then choose your settings, name it. These are the settings I normally use. Then hit Create. And now iMovie will create a trailer project, which gives you the outline, storyboard, and shot list. Now, this is great if you just want to throw together a quick little trailer. It's not really that great if you want to be more creative. It doesn't really let you do much. And sometimes I find it's harder to use than just a normal iMovie project. So to fix that, we go up to File, and then we go down to Convert to New Project, to Project. And what that does is turns it into a completely normal iMovie project. Here, I'm just going to switch this so you can see this better. And it is exactly like a normal iMovie project, except with the cool, you know, music and sound effects and titles. And you could just add, you know, clips or whatever you want to do to it. You can go and change the titles to, you know, whatever you want. I mean, it's completely exactly like a normal project. Another thing you can do, which I enjoy, is this in credits, which is kind of really cool. You can just add your own company in there or your director, and I just find it's fun to add that in there. You just have, you know, all the cool movie stuff effects, which you cannot normally find in text, or if you set up a normal project, you can't find this stuff in there. Okay, so I'm going to go over to the project I made, just so I can show you what I did. Okay, so this is the project I made, and you can see I've got all the clips here. And basically what I did is exactly that. I took a normal project and just edited the, you know, titles to what I wanted and put in my own clips. And there's the music, as you can see. And here's the beginning. So in the beginning of a lot of movie trailers that I've seen, they usually have booms, and as you can see, I have my own booms here. They kind of suck. I've since found better booms, but whatever you do, you know, a boom here in the air can't hurt, so I think it's a good thing to add, you know, some kind of booms in the beginning if you have credits and whatnot. Okay, so we'll continue on here.
In a world where peace prevails and kindness is...
So, as you can see, I severely decreased the pitch of my voice down to here. Now, you can have a friend do this, or you can try to do your own movie trailer voice, you know, like, in a world where peace prevails, or, you know, whatever you want. Just have fun with it. Another thing is that fades to black or white. If you watch this right here, I'll show you. So as you can see, there's a fade to white. Also up here, I have some cross transitions, some more cross transitions, another fade to black. I find in a lot of movie trailers, they fade to black or white a lot, and it just adds drama and character, and I just think it brings a lot to your movie trailer. Okay, so one more thing that I think is really important is the cut to the music. And here I'll show you. Now you'll notice I'll cut right when the music gets to its, you know, high point. Watch. Bum. 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 So as you can see there, every time the music hits this big beat, I cut. And this is probably the most important thing I can say about a movie trailer is, you know, keeping it short and sweet and cutting to the beat of the music. It just keeps people on the edge of their seats and creates a much more exciting experience. Now, one last thing I noticed is that most movie trailers have, like, this fast bunch of clips at the end that kind of just show all these different parts of the movies, and this is how I tried to replicate that right here. So as you can see, same thing, I'm just cutting on the orchestra strike, just adds, you know, just, you know, adds that extra oomph. That's always really fun to do, and, you know, builds the suspense. And then at the end, I just have my logo, which I created, and the end credits and a little swoosh there, and just, you know, wraps it up and makes it, you know, just short and sweet. One more thing that a lot of people like to do is add the cinematic look to their project. So that's easy enough to do. The aspect ratio that we shoot in normally is different than cinematic, so we just add black bars to it. Now if you look on Google Images, you can find green screen with the black bars letterboxing, and that's what I use. So all you do is take it and drag it over a clip, and then you hit green screen, and that's just going to key out the green and just leave the black bars behind. And as you can see, we have, and just stretch it out here, we have now our nice black bars and cinematic look. So that's easy enough to do. And you have yourself a full-blown trailer. Okay, guys, that's it for me. I hope you have fun with this. Please leave comments or questions below. Give it a thumbs up if you like it. And I'll see you around next time.